Cloud cover around here over the next several days with daytime high readings that'll max out only into the mid 30s. That's forecast.
And you're clear.
Sure, I'm a weatherman.
You shouldn't have ginormous table fish like that.
But I'm more than that. I'm a giver. And that's why I drive. I don't have to do it. I want to. And today, I'm going to pick up Larry Potash. This is Conrad in the van in the parking lot.
Hey, Larry.
Oh, this is great.
I'll take you over to that thing. Good.
Thanks. Good to see you. It's been a good 15 minutes
yeah,
since
I
last saw you.
Gosh, we got so much to catch up on.
Yeah.
Oh, I think I just ran someone over.
Uh-oh.
They up? Now they're up.
Yeah,
they're
fine. They got other right. employees.
That guy looked like he was coming up close to retirement age anyhow. What's your biggest surprise of the 25 years you've been at GM?
So the biggest surprise is we were the bastard stepchild when I started here, and now we have become the place to work, place to be.
That's the biggest surprise right? for me. Look, who would think? Like, I came here thinking maybe I'll do a couple years at the old Niner with the hopes that maybe I can right. get a job at a real station across the street. And I don't know whether to feel good or bad anymore.
Well, a lot of it depends on whether Nexstar f***s it all up.
Don't forget when we go to bleep that, to bleep right. Nexstar, not Special shout out to Perry Sook, who I'm sure is watching this morning. He might be laying in the back of the van. So I'm dropping you off with my buddy Eric Ferguson.
Yeah.
Let me give you some background.
Right.
He's the radio guy on The Mix, right? And he has been number one, like we've been number one, kicking everyone's for a long time. So just be nice to him. He's an old DJ. You know, he may not know where he is at this point in his life. So seriously, though, like, you of all people, somehow or other, after all these years, still have more drive than anybody else that I know on our staff.
For me, it's just, I want to beat the ever-loving out of Channel 7 and Good Morning America with every fiber of
that's,
my being.
That's your drive.
That's part
you
of
love
it.
Beating it.
I love kicking their ass.
Yeah. Here's what I don't think most people know about you, Larry. Yeah. You grew up in some pretty tough tough environment, right?
Yeah.
And didn't come from a family of means, or no. You're kind of a self-made man.
I've always just felt like in basketball, not the best basketball player, but I'm going to work as hard as I can. That's all you can do.
Yeah.
All you can do is work as hard as you can.
Wow.
You may not be able to hit a three-pointer, but you can dive on the floor and get the basketball.
Yeah.
That's
exactly.
the metaphor.
Let me ask you this question. Yeah. In a basketball game between me and Lauren Jiggetts, who do you think would win?
I think Lauren Jiggetts would win. I think you may not score a point.
So here's the thing. She went to Harvard. This is what I was saying to her. I got a 17 on the ACT, but she got in the 30s and went to Harvard. But we're both working at the same
time. Absolutely right. She doesn't seem too smart now.
No, she looks like the fool, and I look like the genius.
That's right. I'm totally with you on that.
So that's kind of sad for her. Let's not talk about it in front of
we'll
her.
We'll edit this out.
All right.
Boy, for a radio guy, you're pretty good looking.
Freak, is it cold out here?
Yeah.
We'll be right in.
All right. Enjoy.
Here I am. Are you driving me back?
No. Well, no. You're on your own, actually, from here.
Am I?
I don't know if you've ever seen Larry with alcohol in him.
No.
I'm a sprinter.
Are you?
Oh.
It's not a marathon?
No.
Good thing this is a short segment.
Yeah.
Next time on Conrad in a Van in the Parking Lot.
How were the drinks?
Good.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, I'm a big proponent of drinking at 11 a.m.
Yeah, listen, I'm glad to drive you.
I pick up my good buddy, Eric Ferguson. You won't want to miss it.